guys got a pretty good jump right off the line. Me and McGuire were right neck and neck going into the wash. Tried to shift sixth, and the little 250F wouldn't quite pull it. So down to fifth, tried sixth again, still wouldn't pull it. So after that, I realized it's only going to pull fifth through this deep sand. So just holding it open in fifth, and this guy on the 450 was able to outdrag me through the sand. But then we start battling, so I'm just following these guys up the wash, and we'll get back into the tighter single track up in a minute. Right here comes Carter on my left. He's on my Caleb Russell 350. Unfortunately, his bike blew up on Friday before the race, so was able to get in mine. He put his forks and wheels on it, so I gave him a little bit of a deal. But if any of you guys are in need of a bike for one of these races that I'm going to be at, or if you're local to the Boise area, I'm starting a rental business, so I've got that 350 for rent. My older brother has a 350 that we're also renting out, and then I've got a 300 two-stroke on order that I will also start renting out. So if you're interested, I've got a website linked down in the description. It's forestrentals.com. Check it out if you guys want to rent one of my race bikes for one of these races, or even just for a nice day in the mountains. Yeah. These hill climbs are just so much fun. Just hold the bike wide open, let it eat. Finally get close enough to sneak by that guy, and so right now I've just got McGuire in front of me right here close, and then my buddy Carter's already pretty much long gone, since he's running a little bit better pace than the rest of us. So we're gonna catch up to McGuire and hopefully we make the pass soon. Thank you. Coming into this corkscrew was actually pretty nice. They call it something else, but basically we just wind all the way back to the center and then back out. You can see Carter's already got like 40 seconds on us now. Me and McGuire are close, and then here's a pro that we're gonna catch up to and pass pretty shortly as well. It's getting a little bit dizzy this first lap, but honestly after that it was just super nice to have a spot to relax and actually take some deep breaths, drink some water, because the rest of the track was so rough and so brutal. So it was pretty nice to have a little break in the middle. Right there, McGuire finally makes his mistake, so I get around him, and then after this it's pretty much smooth sailing, clean vision, and just trying to pick smooth lines for the rest of the race. So we're coming in, this is almost the end of lap one, and then I'll kind of speed up the rest of the laps for you guys, so you don't have to just watch me riding alone. But thanks for watching if you made it this far, and again if you make it through the rest of the video. Thank you. I do gotta say it's pretty nice to trust my bike setup and stabilizer enough to do 70 miles an hour wide open, one-handed, take a drink, sit down, chill. Pretty fun just to blast the sound wash as fast as the bike would go. also got to thank all these B riders. Pretty much all of them got out of the way super quick as soon as I knew that I was behind them. So appreciate you guys making way for us to keep racing our pace. That's pretty much the end until the GoPro dies. So again guys, appreciate you watching this video if you made it this far, especially thank you very much for watching the whole thing. And this is about halfway through the fourth lap. We did four more laps, four, eight laps total. Ended up second in the Unlimited A class just behind Carter. And then I took fifth overall out of a big, big class. So pretty stoked on the result. Best finish I've ever had. I beat five of the eight pros and was only one more minute off the sixth one, which is pretty exciting. So ideas up in the air forward next year if we're going to race A class or maybe we'll move up. We'll see.